player to ever pick up a pad over Tokito and Daigo. Roth, I'm not saying length of time playing results, just raw talent.
Well, give me a few more years. Give me a few more years, and I'll let you know the answer to that. But right now, yeah, he's on the very, very short list of all time. Absolutely already on that list.
That said, if there is anyone that can beat this guy in another Elm game, it is his close friend, Rewan.
Yeah, they play a lot, for
These
sure.
These guys play constantly.
Yeah. They were the grand finals of the Justice 2 Pro Series grand finals.
Now, Rewan playing Raiden is actually no surprise. That's who he played in MKX. And he wasn't as well-known. He really blew up in Injustice 2, but MKX has had a resurgence. He's been bodying people with Displacer Raiden.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this character seems a little bit different. It seems maybe a little bit more like Zoning and Footsie's character.
I would definitely describe him as a Zoning or, like, Footsie character for sure.
Yo, this man is already pressing buttons between strings. For real, he just did that.
And this actually might kill.
Really?
Oh, okay. Very, very close. Yeah, Rewind is nutty enough to go for his crushing blow. Oh, wow! There you see.
That was fast.
Now, that lightning movie has a close, medium, and far version of that.
Okay.
He also has excellent range with his normals.
Yeah, even from this range, he can attack.
Yeah, he uses his staff and a lot of normals, and his punches and kicks have really good. His back one, too. Oh.
Wow. Was that maybe a wrong throw tech? Is that why there was a crushing blow? Okay. That makes sense. Okay, got it correctly that time.
Now, Sony is a good pick for Sonic Fox. She, unlike a lot of characters, she doesn't use a weapon, so her range is some of the shortest in this version of the game, but she makes up for it with really, really good mix-ups. She has, like, a very long move list, and she has a lot of overhead and low mix-ups. They're all unsafe, but she makes you guess constantly. Like, her back 1-2 there, the second hits an overhead, and then she has a low to complement it, so... She's very much a high-risk, high-reward mix-up character, which, and Sonic's so good at predicting how you're going to block,
sure.
Mixing you up. It's a great character for him.
That definitely makes sense to me.
Unfortunately for Sonic, he's having a lot of trouble actually getting going because Raiden is so good in the mid-range. Raiden is also a character where the custom character variation really sets him apart. He has his classic moves you'd expect to tell. It's his staff into the ground and it's planted, and then he can do his lightning moves to bounce off of it. A lot of kind of trap or setup moves if he chooses to use those.
Now, at the end of the last round when he was going for the chip out kill, was there anything that Sonic could have done? Is there like a push block or is there anything in that sense?
There's the flawless block where chip is dramatically reduced and you get a reversal. So that's kind of how you would want to push block in this game. And so it's very high skill survivability.
If you block one hit of a string and the next hit of the string, do you have to continue to input the...
You do not. You can hold block and you'll still get the reduced chip thing. So if you're good enough to get it going, you know, you can survive stuff you'd normally be killed by.
What if you block the first hit of a string regularly? Can you then do the special timing block for the second hit of it?
It depends on how big the gap is in the string.
Okay.
I can't remember off the top of my head what the frame, you know.
Okay,
The nerds can look into that minutia later.
For sure.
But, yeah. There will be scenarios where there's enough of a gap and you can flawless block the second hit and then punish it.
But not on a tight string.
Right.
It's a pretty slow chase down for Sonic Fox, as you can see. I mean, those buttons out of Raiden are big.
Right.
Yeah, very fast forward movement.
Now, Sonic Fox has figured out, though, her onion rings are actually really, really, really good in this game. They recover really... It's kind of like Baraka, where they're surprisingly... You normally wouldn't think of her onion rings as being super, super strong, but they are great in this.
Okay. And we saw briefly, I don't know if we've seen it actually connect, but Raiden has a huge anti-air, gigantic forward range on that.
Shot so good.
Oh, man.
Now, this really shows the fatal blow mechanic here because he is now made this comeback, but Sonic is now inflated fatal blow territory.
Right.
And she has an overhead and a low that can link into it, so Rewind could be in a ton of trouble if Sonic gets in. And Sonic got in. He might go for it.
Keeping it safe,
nope,
looks
just
like.
He's going for the pressure.
Was that a low? Yeah.
That was a low, yeah. Sonic's doing a really good job just kind of getting them in range, then blocking. Oh, big jump in.
Okay, let's see what he got.
Now Rewind tries to get out of the corner.
Look at the damage
already. Oh, the short hop! It's so impressive that these guys, I mean, that these guys are Evo champions. They are already using a mechanic like that.
Did you make combat out of the rings? Rewind can't afford that right now. He's too low on life.
And Rewind's just one, basically, throw or low, even in chip damage territory.
What was
the
punish? Okay. Okay, there he goes.
My favorite detail here is the intestine attached to the blade.
So
you could definitely use that if you're really...